to my channel. My name is Rebecca. Please remember to subscribe and like. Today I'm going to be talking about how do I register as a nurse in the UK. This is for people who have trained overseas. Now, before you start, I would advise that make sure you have some money ready and make sure you have written your English language test as well. Now, the first thing is visit or go on Google, check on the UK NMC or Nurses and Midwifery Council's website. When you go on there, you're going to be choosing for the aspect which says you have trained outside of the EU or EEA. So when you click on that, you're going to be doing what we call checking whether you're ready to apply. So under that, they've got some questions to ask, such as what qualifications you have, probably an adult nurse, learning disability, mental health nurse or midwifery. So you have to choose whichever. They would want to know whether you've ever changed your name. They would like to know whether you've had a police caution before, whether you've been registered in the last 3 years, just to make sure that you have some experience before you're applying. If they're happy with all those information, then you progress to the next aspect, which is to create an NMC account. So it's important to polish up your computer skills as well. Try knowing how to start a computer, send emails and do a few things, because you would need that as you go along. If you have completed all those things, then the second stage is checking your eligibility and qualification. They want to have your registration document. They would be asking for your ID, like a passport. You have to upload all those ones. They want to have your English evidence that you have. So with the English test, you either write the IELTS, which is the International English Language Testing System, where they would be assessing your writing, your reading, your speaking and listening skills. Some people write another test, which is referred to as the OET, which is Occupational English Test, or some people actually use their training. But if you want to use your training, then you should have a transcript that would show evidence that 50% of your clinical interactions have been in English, and 75% of those would also must have been with patients, relatives and other health professionals. So you provide all these documents and information, and if they are happy with all these, then you would be paying your £140 to the NMC to evaluate your qualification. I would advise that you follow me and subscribe and join me in my next video, where I'm going to be talking about the second stage. I'll see you soon.